Alright, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another episode of Survival Stories 3. I hope everybody is doing good. I hope that you are seated comfortably and that you are up for some Minecraft with me. And I hope that you're doing amazing, of course. I'm doing pretty okay myself. I gotta say, though, I've had this very terrible week at work. And when I say terrible, I just mean not terrible, you know, but it's been a lot, man. It's been over my ears with work. I've been coming home at 9 every evening, haven't been able to play Minecraft. It's been like that now for 3 weeks, I think, so a little bit sad about it. I think I even mentioned it maybe the last episode, so I shouldn't be whining. I'm not, though. I'm enjoying what I do. It's just even Escal needs his beauty sleep. But I'm here with you now, I'm playing Minecraft, so I'm feeling pretty fine. I have nothing to complain about. Today, last episode, let's bring you in. Last episode, we changed the facade on our man cave thing from the bamboo villa into this. And thank you so much for the love, ladies and gentlemen. I mean, come on now, guys. You are being almost too kind. You're super nice. Today, I want to start off by work out the interior, and I also want to expand the base because I feel like we're gonna be here for a while, and it's kind of tiny as it is right now. It's so small, I get claustrophobic, you know. Actually, Rendog is on the server at the moment, so that's pretty cool. Hi, Cyberdogs! Although they can't hear me, but they're over at the channel as well. I wanted to try some different designs for the interior. I took down the stone floor there. I was thinking maybe let's try do something like this. And maybe we get rid of you and put you there for now. Grass, by the way, you can spread quickly by watering it, as you can see. It's pretty amazing. I know it. And sometimes you have squares where nothing happens. And then it's usually a light source issue because they need a certain light in order to become grass blocks. We have this super nice green color over in this biome, but it's really weird. I noticed this, I think, last time when I was playing around with a little bit of foliage for the facade. If you take a look at vines, they are super green, right? But then this thing isn't super green. And I was like, okay, maybe that's the sword fern that just looks like that, you know? But there are certain things. Let's see. Oh, yeah, over there. This wheat grass. This is biome affected. If I would pick this up, I'm getting sidetracked immediately. If I pick this up and plant it over in some other biome, it would get a different color. But over here, it has this color, which is weird. Which I suppose is like the leaves of the bamboo. So I think it's intentional. It's just a little bit odd. Anyway, we have the green grass, which is the most important thing. You guys know me. I love my green grass. Can't live without it. But, okay, so let's try this. Come on now. Thank you. And then I was thinking maybe we would have a border of maybe oak. Like that. Let's just get a little bit more here, I guess. Okay. And then maybe instead of these, we could try maybe having oak logs. Oops. Set up oak logs like that, okay? And then we'd have this coming over, and we'd have obviously more grass here then. I guess that's not the best demo in the world, so let's do this. Okay, come on now. Give me that feeling. Oh, jeez. That's what I'm talking about. There we go. Okay. Let's try and get one more of these oak things over here, maybe. Oops. Okay, and yeah. Yeah. Voice crack. I like it. It feels very familiar for some reason, though. There's something about this mix that just feels like I've seen it before. I don't really know what it is. Alright, I found a style that I think is a little bit more unique. And that I think looks pretty good. We're gonna go with the grass on like, because I really want this green, right? It's so beautiful. Let's see. Let's bring this boop down here. It's so beautiful, the green grass, and you guys know me. So I want to keep that like settled though in the edges, and we'll have like, yeah, you see what I did here. Then I have like a border of stone going around here, and this is just chiseled cobblestone. And then in the center, I think I want to go with a spruce, because spruce and stone, I mean, you can't really argue with it. It's so freaking gorgeous. So we'll have this. This will wrap around. And when we have an opening, I don't really know how to do it quite yet, but something like that. We'll place, we'll have grass there. And as far as base extension, I think I'm going to punch out both of these walls and build like hallways into where we can extend. We have to do a little bit of infrastructural things today as well though, so I don't want to spend the entire episode on me derping around with building, but I'm a little bit inspired right now to kind of put this down. I find it very tough sometimes when you're like, it's weird, I don't know if you get this, probably you do, probably this is like a common Minecraft thing. When you play as much Minecraft as old Iskal, you've kind of tried most of the styles out, and you kind of know what works and doesn't work, which should, in theory, make building easier and easier the more you play Minecraft. And it does, you know, you kind of learn and you get better at it, like anything. You are able to put down things together quicker. Would this work? Yeah, I think that's gonna work. You're able to put down things quicker. It's actually what I did over here, I realize. You're able to put down things quicker. However, actually, let's try something here. When you do that on YouTube, the issue is that you, as a YouTuber, you kind of know what you've built in the past and you kind of know what you haven't built. You know what I mean? And if you build anything that you have built in the past, I guarantee you that there would be some viewers that say, hey, you've already done this style now. Do something new, please, man. Jeez. Don't you have any creativity? Don't copy Etho. Don't do that. You did that 2 years ago. Yeah, no. You guys doesn't sound... You don't sound like that, okay? You sound more like Vikings, I'm sure. But you get the point. Maybe this is better, though, actually. I think I may like that more. You kind of want everything to be unique every time you do it. And then all of a sudden, when you've done so many different builds and they're on YouTube, it gets a little bit tricky sometimes. But this maybe just is my brain messing with me. But anyway, I kind of like this style here. So instead of having these, then we would have, let's see. Yeah, we'd probably place it the same. So we'd have that there. And then the creeper thing. All right. And I don't think I want to bring any bars across. I think I want to like keep it like this, because we're kind of upgrading it from a mine shaft into a man cave with like, or a jungle temple thing with like structural things, right? So we'll have it something like that. Then I want to clean this up a little bit. I do like having the machine, so I've actually added like a sag mill. And this thing here, these are manual so that I can just go here and smell things and stuff. But I think I want to move them over here and possibly also rewire this stupid lead wire. No one complained about this though, which just had me surprised because it does look pretty bad. So let's do this. I do have my barrel or dolly thing, but I think I want to make a new one because I have a zombird spawner. In between episodes, I've actually been out exploring once again, and I found 2 weapon cases. I actually found like 5 vanilla dungeons, which is pretty crazy. Jeez, my inventory. Hold on. Let's put you there, and maybe we get rid of some stone. For now, I'm just going to plop it there. Yeah, pretty crazy to find like vanilla spawners, spawner rooms in that frequency, but I guess I caved for quite a bit. Rendog was on. And none of us were recording, we're just, you know, hanging out on Skype. Really excited to just, you know, chill out and talk with him. I did find a pig minimob, which we have to make into a pet. We have to get into that pretty soon, actually, because I wanna play with that mod so badly. 2 weapon cases, as I said. I found another diamond Sane. Where is it? There it is. Can you believe it? Another diamond Sane! That's insane. Another task. You see what I just did there? Mm-hmm. But okay, anyway, back to this. I'm thinking we clear this up. Take this presser away that I haven't used. These are... I need to have a wrench on those. Where is Chester's eye? I have a funny story that's actually a little bit awkward. I was out with my dogs earlier today, and for those of you who don't know, I have two dogs. I have a Papillon Hercules, and I have a Siberian Husky Venus. And we have this neighbor girl, she may be 16 or 17, who takes out our dogs every now and then. She's a very nice person. She helps us out a lot when I'm traveling and Emily's working. And she walks the dogs for us, and you know. And it was dark outside because it's Sweden and it gets dark at like 3. I'm gonna try and just expand. We shouldn't have anything in there, no. I'm gonna try, by the way, to just expand here, so that's what I'm kind of doing. I want a hallway, although that's gonna probably end. Oh yeah, the mountain ends there. Crap. Dang it, maybe we do something like this. Yeah, we go in here and then we go up to the left. Okay, anyway, it was kind of dark outside, I didn't see very well. And then I met two teenage girls, and I was absolutely sure that one of them was this girl who takes out our dogs. So I'm like, hi, and she says, hi back. Her friend looks at me weirdly, and I'm like, so how are things? And she's like, well, they're good. And about then, I started realizing that this girl is not the woman who takes out our dogs. She is just a random 16-year-old that I have just randomly started to speak with, which is okay, but it's kind of creepy, I suppose, for her that, because, you know, why would anyone random, like, just say hi to this 16-year-old teenager? No, it's just, you know, I felt so bad. But I just, like, left the conversation and started walking at that point, so I didn't actually tell her anything. Oh, man, she's probably so confused right now, but yeah. If you're watching this, it wasn't a weird perv that you met outside. It was someone thinking that you walked our dogs for, and I'm your neighbor. And yes, I'm very sorry. Okay, thank you. Anyway, we'll do like an expansion in this way. Some kind of hallway and another room, although it's going to be a little bit weird. I also want to have that here, but this way we could just dig straight, I think. I actually think there's a cave behind here, I'm pretty sure. Yes, there's a cave here. Okay, so maybe we will utilize this area. Oh, you know what? Let's skip. Yeah, let's do this. Here's the new plan, okay? Let's skip this entirely. We can keep it for something, but maybe we just close it off here. Okay, and we just dig out. We'll see how far we can get before we hit the... end of the line, which should be like right here. Yep. Okay. So we have a little space for a room there, and then we'll carry out the base extension this way, and we'll kind of try and keep the shape of the cave, because that's never been done before. God dang it! Everything's been done by Etho. Etho is like the Simpsons of Minecraft videos. No. But yeah. Okay. So we expand this way for the cave. So I'm gonna go ahead and put down this style and kind of just like copy what we started to do here. Oops, that's actually wrong. And dig out some rooms, put the ore doubling somewhere, because we're gonna need some rooms for infrastructure basically, so this ought to be done. All right, very good. I got a little bit of base foundation done now, at least. So we saw this room, I've done an extension down this way, and I'm also gonna try my best at like having different heights and stuff, or using like the Y level. I'm usually very bad at that, like I build very straight things, but yeah, we come down here, we have a little bit of greenery on this side, and we've got a room here and further base extension areas. This is just looking like crazy. that we can work with. So that's pretty cool. And then over here, I went ahead and I dug out as far as I could. You remember this is where the exit of the base is that I showed you. Yeah, it's not done or anything, but this gives us a little bit of room where I'm gonna put up the toaster again, but we're gonna make it so much cooler, okay? Really excited about that. Let's get to that in a second. First though, I'd like to kind of change our power situation here. I don't love the flux ducts in the ceiling, and I don't really love having this thing in the center. The reason I put it here from the beginning was that I really want... I'm gonna need a bucket. I really wanted it to be kind of central, if you know, to the base. We can still do that, but we're gonna put it underground. And I also put this up kind of off camera, and I realized a few people, including Rendog, was like, hey, I didn't really understand what was going on there. This is what Rendog said, and so maybe you can teach me. So yes, Ren, this is for you. I'm gonna reset up my power generator. He uses survivalist generators. Survivalist generators, come on now. I mean, that's good and all, but we are a little bit more advanced. No, I'm just joking. But basically, the thing that generates power for us is this steam dynamo here. This is an engine, and you put coal in here, and then you produce steam through heating it up, and it actually produces steam itself. You heat up water. So you need a water source, and you need coal, and then it will generate power. And this bad boy actually generates 80 RF per tick, whereas the survivalist generator does 5 RF per tick. We may actually want to upgrade this as well in this episode. So far, we've been sufficient on power, no problems, but you can upgrade it, and maybe we want to do that. So, the first thing, though, I'm going to move it, so let's take this down. And by the way, this is like a few hours later, because the server has been acting up, unfortunately. I think there's something wrong with, like, something. It's not my connection, because my fan server is working fine. It's not cubed host necessarily. I think it's just this specific. I think it's this specific server. I think like the computer that it's on or something is broken. I need to clear up my inventory badly. This happens every time. Where's that stupid smite axe? There we go. Okay, maybe I put the sword there. I made some scissors from Botania as well in between episodes. Use them instead of regular. And yeah, that's good. Okay. So my idea, let's do something simple here, because I mean, it's going to be very temporary. The thing we need to access from above is a coal input, right? The rest, we don't really need to access. So I'm thinking we'll just lower this whole thing. We'll make a water source, and I'm going to need the stuff that I just put away. Crap. I miss having flight. Okay, I'm going to need you, I'm going to need you, and I'm going to need you. And I have the water. Okay. So here's how you do it. Water. Dig a 3 long, 1 wide hole or trench. And then put the water in there. To make a vanilla source thing, you can pick up the middle block without anything happening. Then put down any block on that. That's a temporary block. And then you're going to use a transfer node for liquids. Plop that like so. Open it up. Put a world interaction upgrade, which is a thing you make like this, into this. And now, if you remove this, this will generate water. Okay? Now, there are several ways in the pack to generate water. There are even machines that does that for you. But this is, I think, the cheapest way and the most commonly used, at least that I use. And then, if we remember, we just need to pump water into this. So, I'm just going to connect this up to the thing, like a zoo. And now... does have a little pipe connected, and we can see that it fills up with water. So now we just need to feed it coal, and then we can basically grab power from it. Now, I can't really remember. I think we can flip this like so. I think water will still flow in from the side. The only thing that's important, and I didn't bring the power cables. Holy crap. So disorganized. Let's actually get some more. I think I should have some more. I think they're in this chest though. Yes, okay, good stuff. Let's do a power cable. I think the power cable needs to come out this way. Pretty sure. Yes, doesn't connect there. Okay, so what we'll do is kind of have, you know what, maybe we can do something like this instead. Let's flip this back like so. Okay, let's then put, oh my goodness, my energy cell, and now the server's lagging. Come on now. See, this is what happens. It's like spikes. There we go. Okay, woke up. I'm gonna have to kind of restart it and contact the support once I'm done with this episode. But I'm so excited for the next part here. Now, I'm gonna put the energy cell on top of that. This energy cell is like a battery. And then we're gonna have the bottom part is gonna be blue because that's input. All the others can actually be orange. Although I don't think we're gonna use all the other sides. But, well, that's how it's gonna be. And then I was thinking we can run cables underneath the floor to the place we need. So we need one cable going this way to the toast room or the food production room, plop like so. And we're probably going to need a wire this way. So I'm just going to prepare that a little bit, like a cable like that. And that's pretty much it. We need a coal input, of course, as well. So let's grab them item ducts. Going to need some more. Jeez. You know what I try and do? And this, I mean, this sounds crazy because you can clearly see that I miss a lot of things. But before I start recording again, like after I've had a cutscene segment, regardless of how long that cutscene segment is, one thing that I try to do is like figure out, okay, so I'm going to need these few things in the next segment. And I always mess up. Okay. Anyway, I think I want to see this from above. Because I may want to check the power and right click on it. So I'm going to place a barrel and you can actually place these like so. Boop. Yep. So now if I put coal in here, you'll see that it's like visible from above. Lock that and then just connect up an item duct like so. Rendo, by the way, does a very good job at explaining, like, he's new to the mods or many of the mods. And I know CyberDogs are, well, some CyberDogs I've seen his comments are just amazingly technical. But he does a really good job at explaining these things. I may skip a few things simply because I know a lot of you are actually probably better than me on modded and you're more interested maybe in inspiration around stuff. So that may be a thing that differs between me and Randog, our series. But I'm going to try and explain a few things. Anyway, that's now going to feed coal into the steam dynamo. Beautiful. And we can go ahead and just store all our coal in there like so. And that's basically our power setup. I think then I want to wrap like some glass maybe around this. So I'll have, this is one of my favorite glass, steel frame. So we'll have something like that, although that looks pretty bad and I want to access this. You know what we can do? Check this out. Let's make something from carpenter's block that is just amazing. Let's make a latch or hatch or whatever it's called. We're going to need a little bit of carpentry. I think that's going to be... Is that enough? No. Do I have any more in here? Yep. Okay. So let's make this a carpenter's hatch. This thing is amazing. This is how they are supposed to be in vanilla, but never really got to be. Basically, it's a trapdoor, but it can be completely flush with the floor. So if I, for example, right-click a spruce... You can see that there's no difference. And now let's actually completely skip. I know I just said that I wanted glass here, but let's completely skip that. I'm going to grab my pickaxe because I don't have a lot of glass. I'm going to grab my silk touch one. What was I saying? Oh yeah, the carpenter's hatch. So now if I just cover this up like this, we have a hidden system that we can access. We can check our power. And you can even, if you want to, again, this is for the people that are new to modded or new to carpenter blocks. You can right click with the carpenter hammer and you can change this if you want to have like a little window there. Maybe we do it like that actually. That looks pretty good. I like it. I don't think you bump up on it. No, it's completely flush. Okay, so that's fantastic. That's fantastico. That's what we're going to do. Cool. Now, for the exciting part, and this, ladies and gentlemen, wow, I've been waiting so long to be able to use this. I tried to get this in Survival Stories 2 already, but I couldn't. Immersive Engineering is a super cool mod. We're going to get into it. We're going to have a base that is certainly powered from Immersive Engineering. It's basically like a technical mod. All the things that it has, like water wheels and all that, it's super cool. You know, I really do like it and I think it's awesome. But the thing that excites me the most is the conveyor belts. These bad boys act as like item ducts, and You remember, for those of you who've been here for a while, in Survival Stories 2, we made a lot of machines that were, like, ridiculously big. They didn't need to be as big. Like, we made a cow cooker where, basically, cows were shoved through a conveyor belt into a machine, then slayed and cooked, and we got meat out of it. And that's how I like to play modern Minecraft. I like to, like, instead of making things super efficient, let's make things cool and fun, you know? And I think, I mean, I got a lot of cred for doing that cow farm like a year ago, and I've seen Etho in his Let's Play Modded series. He's also doing this stuff now, so I think, I mean, that's the way to do it. Anyway, as you can see, these are super cool. They're also very cheap to make, like it's leather and iron, you get 8, it's fantastic. There was conveyor belts before as well, but they didn't look as good as these. So what I'm thinking is, we'll have a conveyor belt like so. Out here, we'll do a wheat farm. So I'll go ahead and place down like a, for now, manual wheat farm, but later we'll automate this, maybe next time, maybe next episode. The wheat will go in here, and then over here, I'm thinking we'll have our pulverizer. Okay, we'll put that there. And I think, I haven't really played around with this, but I think these acts just like item docks. So if I do that, and then I input something that can be pulverized. Yes, that's getting sucked up by the pulverizer beautifully. Okay, so we don't need anything else. That just feeds it in. That's very good. Okay, and then from there, that gives us the flour. We're going to bring it over. It's going to output on these conveyor belts once again into the redstone furnace. Okay, you see what I'm doing? And we're going to put the trivection chamber in here. Actually, I'm going to plop out that. Okay, that doubles the food. Once again, if you didn't listen the first time we did it, we're going to have an input there. Now, here's where it gets a little bit tricky, because now we want to take that flour and we want to this makes flour into bread. Yeah, so we get bread here. We want to take that and we want to recook it. And I think what we'll do is have an item dock there, and then we'll have it like, maybe do it like that. And I don't know if this is going to work, because, I don't know, can you right-click these, or can you filter these? I don't think so. Let's try this anyway, though. We're going to have the output there, okay, and then we're going to have an input on the back. And then what we can do is, let's grab a servo, and let's first of all make sure that we cook up some wheat or some bread. Do I have any? Please have some spare. Thank you. Okay, so let's just try this for now, how it is. Boop, pop that in. That gets pulverized, it gets spit out to flour, super cool. Gets cooked up to bread if we would have power, which we don't. Crap. Hold on, I have another redstone furnace. I actually made a new one because I was considering having two redstone furnaces for this. But I think we can get away with one. Let's put this one here. This is the old one. It should have power internally. Yep, okay. Let's drop you back. That's getting cooked up to bread. Now, here's what I don't know if this will work, but let's put a whitelist for bread here, okay? And let's disable you. That should definitely grab the bread. The question is, if I have an output here as well, on the right-hand side, and then continue my conveyor belt, will bread eventually pop out this way onto a conveyor belt? Because over here, I only want the final toast to be popped out into storage, you know? So let's try that now. Wheat goes in, turns into pulver, turns into bread. Crap! Okay, so this seems to have priority over this thing. Let's try that again. Let's just make sure that it's consistent. Now my dog is singing. Crap, okay. This isn't as quick, basically, is the problem. Alright, you know what? We're just gonna make this like so. We're gonna have two redstone furnaces instead. Now, this isn't the most efficient way. We could have just taken an item dock. Like, we could have done something like this. Okay, and then we could have, instead of having this here, we could have had a filter on the item dock. Because I think item docks can also output directly to conveyor belts. Actually, I kind of want to know that. Oops, this is facing the wrong way. Yeah. Item docks can certainly output directly there, so we could have had this in between and then a filter, but let's be honest, folks, that doesn't look as cool, not even close. So let's just do two furnaces. It's not like, you know, it's not like we can't have that. So basically, flour, bread, toast, okay? And then from there, I want to shove it. Where's my shovel? Where are my tools, man? Jeez. from there, I want to shove it. Hold on. I want to shove it into this area, around this corner, behind the wall, and then I want to store them right here. Now, I have future plans for this, okay? So, yeah, that's exactly what I want. So we'll run a conveyor belt like this, and I'm gonna need to dig in here. I have future plans for this to add on to this. So we'll do that, and this is gonna be tricky. Boop, there we go. And I've gotta get out, gotta get out. Come on, come on, come on. Okay, there we go. So now, if we would have had power here, which we don't. Hold on, I know a solution for this. Let me grab you real quick, buddy. I'm just gonna borrow you. And I'm gonna power you like so. Okay. So now, let's just see if we get... We should get toast over there. We should get 4 toast per every 1 wheat that goes in. Okay, flour, bread, toast. Oh, crap, I had my magnet on. Okay. Let's remove you, stupid magnet. I don't think I want to have the magnet on me while... Let's just do that again. I don't think I want to have my magnet on me while I'm in base. Because that's really going to mess up a lot of my machines. But okay, so that's super cool. Bread goes in there, or toast goes in there, and it should come out here. Yep, fantastic. Okay. I love it, you know, I really do. It looks so cool. Now, what we can do, and this is a new mod that's in this pack. Let's just put this junk here for now. We're going to need 2 iron doors and 2 chests. And then we're going to make a fridge, or 2 of them. Okay, this is how we're going to store our toast. As I was saying, I have future plans. We can add on to this. Just a little hint, if I would add, say, maybe meat over here, we could make this into a hamburger factory. Maybe that's something that we do pretty soon, because I do miss my hamburgers. Okay, so that's a beautiful fridge from Cooking for Blockheads. I like it. Let's just see if it can store the thing. So let's run this one more time. I'll never get tired of this when it's fully automated and when we can just, you know, our base kind of comes alive. There goes the toast. Hopefully it enters correctly. Otherwise, we have to do something different here. Okay. And it enters correctly. Fan-frickin-tastic. Okay. Oh, actually, look at that. It's actually visible while I have it open. It's too bad that I can't, like, keep it open for longer. Oh, and now it just froze. Okay, I did clean this up just a little bit. We're gonna go inside and take a look. I just wanted to be flowing. I haven't planted the wheat yet. We'll probably have to do that next time though, because we are running out of time, or I'm running out of time in real life. But yeah, baby, check that out. Wow. Oh, that's so cool. it actually made me want to have, like, oh no, crap. Stupid magnet. Dang it. I probably want to have a little bit more of a space in between. Let's just pick these bad boys up. Maybe like space the machines out a little bit, because it does feel a little bit... Oops, that's not going to work. Yeah, it does feel a little bit cramped, like it's a little bit... it doesn't travel very far, is what I'm trying to say. would be cooler to see, like... See the wheat for a while and then see the flour. So maybe I'll change this up slightly, but you get the idea of what I want. I also changed out the fridge for a barrel again, because I realized the fridge is going to get full really quickly. And I didn't think it fitted too well in this room. It's a very cool block though. We'll certainly use it. But maybe for a more modern build, perhaps. But anyway, I really like this. Our new Toastmaster. And like I said, we'll implement like beef over here and make hamburgers, and that will just be a full production band. This is just to give you a taste of how I want to play this series. You see, I want to have, a lot of you have been saying in the comments, please, this Scalda industrial build again. like we did in season 2, and I will, okay? That's the main plan for the headquarters, for the base. It's going to be industrial, it's going to be factorization-wise. But we kind of need like a starting hut, I've been talking about that, and I want to make it like... I don't see a point in playing Minecraft half-assed, if you will. I want to have things here that are cool as well. That reminds us of the beginning later on in the series. Anyway, I still have a few things to clean up here. I did go ahead and like fix a little bit of background, used marble on the back. Ran out of marble, so it looks a little bit weird. And yeah, I have to clear up like the walls and stuff. But I have to get going. I'm actually heading to the grocery store. Emily is out with her friends at the moment, and she thinks that she's gonna be having to cook and stuff when she comes home. But Iskel is gonna surprise the lady a little bit, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna go and I'm gonna pick up some food, make a little bit of dinner, have a good evening. So that's gonna do it for today. I hope that you have enjoyed it. If you do have any ideas or suggestions for like blocks that you like feel for this man cave, you're like, wow, Iskel, how can you miss this block? It's so beautiful, it's so gorgeous, and you don't use it. Please do let me know down below in the comments, and keep liking the videos, keep giving me all the love. I need it, you know? thank you so much though, and I see you in the next episode.